Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to set up the local test domains and enable the trusted self-signed certificate for the browsers. Most of the time, we will have the scenario to have different domains other than the localhost to test the applications locally and also to have trusted self-signed SSL certificates. A self-signed certificate is a certificate that is signed by the person creating it, rather than a trusted certificate authority. The development servers can be enabled with self-signed certificates that will help us to reduce the certificate cost, also the management overheads. By default, the self-signed certificate throws a certificate validity error while accessing the website in the browsers, but will allow us to proceed to the actual pages by accepting the risk. In some cases, the self-signed certificates won't help us to test some of the browser functionalities that only works through valid SSL. Example, testing different browsers APIs like geolocation. Let us see the default behavior. Let me access localhost website enabled with the self-signed certificate. Let me go here. https localhost. Yeah, you can see the message, your connection is not private. So, but here there is an option. You can go to advanced. Then you can say continue to localhost. Yeah, so this not secure error will be displayed, but you will be able to access the website. If I go here, yeah, it says certificate is not valid. Let us now see how to quickly set up the local domains and trusted self-signed certificate for testing in Windows. The same can be used with other systems with some additional steps. Sometimes we may need to have different domains to test our application in the development environment. The DNS setup will consume more time and cost. The local domains helps us to test the applications quickly in the development environments. I'm going to define the following test domains: myexample.com, sub.myexample.com and myexample1.com. To do that, edit the Windows host file. Yeah, this is the Windows host file, like C Windows System 32 drivers, etc host. Add the below entries to map the test domains to 127.0.0.1 so that the defined domains will be able to access the applications running on localhost within the same machine. Now I am able to access the local application through the test domains. Let me show that. Yep. Same thing, https, I'm going with my or example.com. Yeah, so I'm seeing the same application, it's pointing to the same application. Let us now create a self-signed certificate through OpenSSL. As a first step, let us create an RSA 2048 key and save it to a file called rootca.key. So for that, I'm going to execute this specific command, OpenSSL gen RSA, then dest3 out, this is the output file, rootca.key. Then the key size 2048. Let me execute this. Okay. Yeah, you should provide the passphrase for the root key. So, and you store it securely. You need this in the further steps. Okay, the root CA key is generated now. Let us now create a root certificate through the root key generated. For that, I'm going to execute this specific command. OpenSSL req, then x509, then the key, you need to specify the key, then the algorithm, then the days, like validity days. You can change the validity day as per your requirement. Then output, where this root certificate should be stored. Okay, here like again, fast phrase for the root key, whatever we entered earlier, same thing. Okay, fine now, enter the country name. You can go with the default or if you want, you can enter some values. Then like state, again, you can go with the default also. Yeah, now I'm just saying, yeah, some name. Yeah, then organizational unit name, I may say marketing something. Yeah, the common name, this is the one for the root certificate name. So I am saying local certificate. then email address, I can say admin. That's fine. Yeah, now the root certificate is generated. Let us now trust the root SSL certificate in the local system. For that, I'm going to run this command, certutil add store, then root, then the root certificate name. So this would be executed through the elevated access. Okay, I'm going to run as an administrator. That's fine. Okay, I need to cd. Okay, fine, then copy this command. Now the root certificate is added as part of the trusted root certificate authorities. You can verify the certificate through certificate manager or Certmgr.msc utility. So let me go and do that. Type here cert. Yeah, you can see manage user certificates. Click on that. Trusted root certification authorities. Click on then certificates. If you see here, like type local, yeah, you can see the local certificate. It's added as part of the trusted root certificates. Even the root certificate can be managed through different browsers. Let us see how to do that in Chrome. Let me open Chrome, go to settings, then privacy and security, then go to security. If come down, then you can see something called manage certificates. Click on that. So this will open the same Windows Cert Manager. So you can see here trusted root certificate authorities. Local certificate. Yeah, you can see the same certificate here. Even you can import, export, and remove the certificate. So import the certificate or export. But you will not be able to remove the certificate installed through that Cert Manager, whatever we did it. So otherwise, whatever the certificate you are importing from here, you will be able to remove it. So even you can see the certificate details here, like if you double click, you can see here, yeah, issued by local certificate, issued to, then valid from, valid to. Firefox won't consider the root certificates from the Windows Cert Store, but Chrome and Edge do. The self-signed root certificate should be imported separately to Firefox. Let me do that. Let me go to Firefox. Yep. Okay, go to options, then privacy and security, that's fine, come down. Here you can see view certificates, click on that. Authorities, so import. Okay, you can go and import the certificate. Okay, rootca.pem. I'm selecting that, open. Yeah, you need to click on this, trust this CA to identify websites. Click on that and click OK. Yeah, now the certificate would have installed. You can see the local certificate. You can even see the details also here. So even you can export the certificate, or even you can delete. Click OK. It's fine. The root certificate is trusted now. Let us issue an SSL certificate to support our local domains. For that, create a open SSL configuration file with the name server.csr.cnf. Let me show that. Okay, yeah, this is the file server.csr.cnf. Here you can define this detail so that you don't want to enter those details manually while generating the certificate. So, yeah, so that all these values, the country, then state, and locality, and all those things. Now, again, create a file with the name v3.ext so to list out all the local SAN domains. So, yeah, this is the file v3.ext. So if you see here, yeah, there is some basic details, then subject alternative names. So I'm defining this many domains. myexample.com, then sub.myexample.com, myexample1.com, also I added localhost. Let us now create a private key and CSR for the localhost certificate. CSR means a certificate signing request. I'm going to execute this specific command. So if I go here, yeah, this one. OpenSSL request, then you can specify the output is server.csr, then RSA 2048, then where this key should be stored, server.key. Then we are specifying the configuration file name, what we created, server.csr.cnf. So let me go and execute. Okay, the private key is returned to this file, the server.key file. Now let us issue a certificate through this root SSL certificate and the CSR what we created here. So for that, again, we should be executing this command. Again, like what is a CSR file, then server.csr, then what is the root certificate, then root certificate key, then output is server.crt. Here again you can say the validity days, if you want you can change it. Then extension file you need to specify here, because the domains are configured in that extension file, v3.ext. So let me go and execute this. Yeah, here you need to enter the passphrase for the root key. Yeah, now the certificate is created. Let me go and show you. Yeah, like server.key and server.crt. Let us now enable the certificate for the local server. I am going to configure the certificate with express.js server to enable the trusted SSL communication. But the same certificate can be configured through other servers like Apache. So let me show you that. Yeah, this is the app.js file. I'm using HTTPS module, then creating the server. Here, this is the key, certificate key, then server.key, then this is the actual certificate, server.crt. So I'm listening on this 443 port. So let me quickly restart the server. So this is fine if I go and do this. Let me now go and access the website. So I will go to this browser, then, yep, that's fine. Let me HTTPS. localhost, this is fine. Yeah, you can see this, the certificate is accepted now, or it's valid, it's saying certificate valid. So this same certificate will be used for like other domains also, you can see here. Yeah, subject alternative names, so this support all these domains. Now even if I access with other domain, ps/myexample.com, the certificate will be valid. Now, if I want to go to Firefox, then I can do that. The certificate will be valid there also. https://localhost. Yeah, you can see the certificate is valid because we even installed that root certificate to the Firefox. Now, same case, if I go to Edge, you will see the same behavior. It was earlier, it was not. Yeah, now you can see the certificate is valid and trusted. So the trusted self-signed certificate along with local domains can be used for development and initial testing. This will help us to quickly enable trusted local domains to test some of the scenarios that require the trusted SSL certificate. So that's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.